Hello friends, welcome to a new episode of Yantriki. So far we have discussed number of concepts of strength of material. Today I would like to discuss about hardness and toughness. So here on the board you can see I have tried to compare these two properties, this hardness and toughness. So let us take one by one. So first, hardness. So hardness is a property of a material due to which the material shows resistance to scratch or abrasion. This is the shortest definition that you can say about hardness. Other ways of looking at hardness can be like when you go for any solid model, solid matter. So you can say that hardness is a measure of how resistant a solid matter is to various kinds of permanent shape change when a compressive force is applied on it. Some materials are harder than the others. So macroscopic hardness is generally characterized by the strong intermolecular bonds. So whenever I am talking about hardness, I can consider that intermolecular bonds are probably responsible. Intermolecular bonds are probably responsible, but the behavior of solid materials under force is too much complex, and that's why there are various types of hardness tests that can be conducted. So here I have written some examples. Like if I have to conduct, say, scratch hardness test, what I will conduct is famous test that we call as the Morse test. So in the same way, as I said that solid models have more complex, you can say, tests to be carried out for hardness. So we have Brinell test, we have Rockwell test, Vickers test, and Noob's hardness test. So these are the different hardness tests for different types of, as I already mentioned, that hardness is a complex, you can say, property. That's why we have different types of tests carried out. And that is one reason we do not have a specific SI unit for hardness. Hardness has different scales rather than different SI units. Now, coming back to this toughness, I would like to bring in your notice this unit that I have written, that is joule per cubic meter. Often this question is asked in exams, that what is the SI unit for toughness? So, and what exactly is toughness? So let us start with this SI unit. You have already seen it's joule per meter cube. So joule will be representing obviously the energy, and meter per cubic meter is representing the volume. So I can say resistance against fracture, I will use this word fracture. So we can have the simplest definition of toughness, that it can be defined as the material's resistance to fracture when it is stressed. So whenever stress is applied, so if the material is resistance against fracture, it will be considered as toughness. A very famous test that is carried out to measure toughness is the Izod and Charpy test. Toughness is the property which enables the material to absorb the energy without fracture. This is the second definition. So absorbing energy without fracture. This is another one. So again, you see this energy term is used, giving you the SI unit of joule. I will always, whenever you you feel that what is toughness, you always remember this, and then you will get the definition that energy without fracture, absorbing some amount of energy. See, this is a material, it is absorbing some amount of energy before it has got this fracture. So that is one way of looking at it. This property is very desirable in case of cyclic loading and shock loading. So cyclic loading and shock loading, if you look at this one, the Charpy and Izod test, it is conducted like this kind of a specimen is taken with a notch in it, and then the hammer is coming towards it and finally breaking this part. Now this is coming all of a sudden, and that's why it is shock loading. So look at another way of looking at toughness can be that it is the property which is desirable in case of shock loading. If a metal is tough, then it has ability to store large amount of energy. Which energy? Strain energy. So this energy I am talking about, this energy is which energy basically? Strain energy. So about strain energy, I have made one video that you can refer in order to understand more about strain energy. So here in the concept of toughness, I can now say that if material will be tough if it has the ability to store large strain energy before fracture. In order to be tough, a material should be both strong as well as ductile. It should have strength as well as it should be ductile to be tough. Or you can say toughness is a balance between these two properties, strength and being ductile. For example, I will take, say there is a brittle material, I will consider say ceramics. Ceramics is a brittle material, we all know this. Now, what happens in case of ceramics? Ceramic is very strong, but it lacks ductility. So, as it lacks ductility, it cannot be considered as a tough material. The opposite to that is also true. What it means, if suppose some material is there which is lagging in strength, but then it is ductile, then also it will not be considered as tough. To be tough, the material should be able to withstand high stress and high strains. So toughness comes with high value of stress and high value of strain. Both these things should be high. Again, most of my, you can say, friends, they ask me this question, that what is the difference between strength and toughness then? What is the difference between strength and toughness? So strength is like how much force the material can support or how much load the particular material can sustain. But toughness is how much energy a material can absorb before rupturing. So to sum up, I have this SI unit that can help you always when you are dealing with toughness, whereas hardness is just the resistance to scratch or abrasion. I hope you got a brief idea about toughness and hardness. In my next video, I will be telling you more concepts of strength of material. Thank you for watching.